Hello, everybody. Today I'm going to be reading Diary of a Wimpy Kid Blood Brother by u/j-ashton on Reddit. And yeah, I don't really have a lot to say for an intro. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you for all the support recently. Hit that subscribe button. I think we could definitely hit like 5k by the end of the summer. That would be super cool. But yeah, let's get straight into Diary of a Wimpy Kid Blood Brother. Thursday. Manny's been acting really strange lately. It's honestly annoying. Seeing him drag his old blanket around for 4 hours a day, then him sitting down to watch some evil TV show, then him drawing about it. It's only annoying because he does it every day while eating cereal or something. Friday. So Manny did the same thing today that he does every day. The only other thing he did today was stare at Roderick. Big Bubby die. At least he would say something every 20 minutes. Well, I'm not sure what he meant by that, but it's fine. Manny just came into my room. Rally gone. That's a bit weird. What does he mean by rally gone? Well, I guess I'll ask Rally about it tomorrow. Saturday. So I went over to Rally's house and he was acting really weird. Then he told me about him marrying Manny. Okay, that's pretty weird. I then thwapped Rally. The only reason I thwapped him was because he really wasn't acting like himself. But anyway, Roderick hasn't come out of his room since Manny went there. I think I'll check up on him if he doesn't come upstairs by tomorrow. Sunday. Well, Roderick's dead. Well, I'm like 80% sure he is anyway. I went to his room and I found him, I think, dead. His blanket was pulled over almost all of him, but I don't even know how this happened. The last person who went downstairs was Manny, but he's three. What could he do? Anyway, this whole Roderick thing is pretty tiring, so I'll figure it out tomorrow. Monday. So Dad's dead too, and once again, Manny was the one who was last with him, so I confronted him. I'm own we three. Pretty sure he has nothing to do with it. But anyway, Roderick's funeral is tomorrow. I think I'll go, since he was my brother, after all. But I'll write a little more today. Nothing really exciting has happened today. Oh wait, I saw Rally again. He told me he broke up with Manny yesterday for our friendship. There isn't an our friendship anymore. That's because of what I did next, was laugh hysterically at him. Okay, in my defense, it was hilarious. I'm pretty sure I made Rally hate me. Maybe he'll ask Manny to marry him again. September. Okay, before you get mad at me for not writing this for 4 days, I have a good reason. Rally begged Manny to marry him again, and Manny agreed. Mom said their wedding is this Sunday. I can't let this happen. Not because I like Manny and all, but because I do not need Rally as a step-sibling. I'm gonna start planning ways to make Rally and Manny's wedding horrible. Maybe I can ask Fragley to ruin it for me. I'll ask Ruby Bird too, since they recently started dating. Wait, how is Rally going to be his step-sibling? Wouldn't he be his brother-in-law? Wait, is Manny Greg's father? What? Anyway, I don't know. Maybe I'm thinking too much, bro. I'm using, like, over 10%. I'm using 100% of my brain. That's what happens. Instead of 10. If I do end up asking them, let's hope they don't bite me. Saturday. So I decided I asked Fragley. And he said yes. And so did Ruby. So I'm going to spend all day thinking of ways to ruin their wedding. Plan 1. Have Ruby and Fragley bite everyone there. Plan 2. Have Fragley go crazy. Plan 3. Cut Fragley and Ruby and make a speech about things up I made up about Manny. But I don't really feel like hearing screams from getting bit or giving a speech. I'll go for plan 2. The wedding. So I'm at the wedding and I'm about to tell Fragley and Ruby to go crazy. Okay, I just told them. Let's just wait for the fun to begin. Just about everyone got scared and left, and for the ones that didn't, well, yeah, it was crazy. And even at the end, Manny and Rally said nothing, just stared blankly. I'm gonna get this all off my mind by hosting a sleepover tomorrow. I'll invite Albert, Shirog, and Tyson. Monday. So for the most part, the sleepover was good. Tyson couldn't come, but Shirog and Albert did, so we hung out and played some video games. When we went upstairs is when things went downhill. Albert said he had to use the bathroom and walked by Manny's room. From what Shirog told me, Manny was doing a demonic ritual on his friend Megan. And apparently, when Manny saw that Albert was watching him, Manny shoved the froyo stick down his throat. Mom and Dad were no help, as they once again defended Manny. Wait, how is his dad back? What? It doesn't matter. Don't think about it too much. You know what? Me and Shirog will just go to sleep and hope Manny doesn't do anything till then. Tuesday. Boy, was I wrong. Let me explain. So he didn't have school because several kids at my school were murdered, so he decided to cancel it today altogether. And when I woke up today, Shrog was also dead. I instantly knew who did it. Manny. I would try to kill Manny, but who knows what that kid's capable of. I wonder who his next victim is. Wait, about 8 kids died the same night Shrog did. And apparently all those kids were killed by a tiny perpetrator. Yep, definitely Manny. I can't kill Manny, but I could get him arrested. Thing is, I don't have any proof to get Manny arrested. I don't feel like I'm, like, doing this right now, so I'll just live with the fact that I'm living with a murderer. Manny just left. Who knows where, but he left the house. You know what? I don't even care. That little demon can go wherever he wants. Let's just hope he never comes back. Wednesday. So Manny came back at 5 in the morning. Mom woke me up and said there was an incident in Manny's room and he had to sleep in my room for a while. Then she shut the door and turned off the lights. We were in silence for a straight 10 minutes until he whispered 2 words into my ear. Puppy, die. He just stabbed me 5 times in the chest. Help, it was always Manny. He did it all. Whoever reads this, find and kill Manny. And that's the end. Oh, Greg got shot. Well, anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. I actually really like this one. You know, it's just a classic, just like goofy, unserious fanfiction. We need more books like this. Bro, if this was like put in libraries, this is what the kids would be reading nowadays. This would make kids want to read. This makes me want to read. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and like the video. Hit the post notification bell not to miss any more Wimpy Kid videos. And yeah, I don't know what else to say. Just subscribe if you want to tope on Manny. Goodbye.